Good morning, Crossville Baptist. It's so good to see you today. Just a couple of announcements just before we get started. Is number one, we have started Sunday school back. We started last week. It was such a good time. It was really good to fellowship in that way. So I just want to invite you to join us right after worship this morning to Sunday school. It starts at 9:45. And we all have our individual classrooms. Go enjoy it. Go enjoy the fellowship with each other. Just keep your social distance, and you should have a good time. And just don't forget that food drive is coming up at the end of the month. All right? With that being said, let's start our worship service off with some prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord, I just thank you so much for gathering us here this morning. I thank you, Lord, for again, it seems like a broken record, but you never fail us, Lord. Thank you again just for the beautiful weather that we have. Thank you that we're able. And God, I just pray, Lord, that you are honored and you are blessed through this service this morning. May you speak to our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning, Croswell and neighbors and those online. Welcome back. It's so good to be able to be up here and worship with you. I've really missed hearing your voices in the sanctuary, but I'm hoping you're singing in the car. All those that have their phone apps open or are watching online, the lyrics are available. And I just hope you're out there ready to sing and worship with us this morning.
Skin. Good morning, Croswell. It is so good to see you. Honk, honk, honk. I hope you have had a great week and that you are coming here today excited about the opportunity to worship the Lord. And I hope we never lose sight that we have that opportunity. There's so many people in our world today that don't have that opportunity. And so even if it's different, we're not sitting in our pews like we're used to, or we're not together, knowing that God is still the same and that we can worship Him is a beautiful thing. So today I wanted to talk to you, our kiddos, about God doing big things and little things. In Exodus, there's a story of Moses leading the Israelites out of captivity. And in this story, they get to the Red Sea, and everyone's scared because they see the Egyptians coming for them, and they're very afraid. And Moses tells them to just calm down and watch God protect you. And God instructs Moses to reach his hand out over the waters, and God sends a big wind that holds the waters up for them to travel through. And that's a pretty big deal. That's a pretty big miracle for this vast amount or a lot of water to be moved over so that people could walk through. And in our lives, there's things that happen and we pray for these big things. And we think that God, sometimes in my life, I thought God only cares about the big things in our life. But what's really important, and there's one word or a couple of words in this passage that I want to point out to you. It says, "Then Moses raised his hand over the sea, and the Lord opened up a path through the water with a strong east wind. The wind blew all that night, turning the seabed into dry land." Now, I think about if I'm at like the beach or maybe the lake, water or the land that's right near the water, when you're trying to walk on it and it's wet, it is hard to get through. It can kind of trip you up. But God knew that they were going to need dry land. So we talk about these big things that God does, and it was an amazing miracle that God did in moving the water for the Israelites to get through. And the rest of the story, there's so much more to the story where God messes up the wheels of the Egyptians, of their chariots, so they can't get to them, and God ends up washing them out so that the Israelites are safe. But I think what we overlook sometimes, and we think that God doesn't care about the little things in our life. He took care of making that land dry. After all of that water had been on top of it, God made that land dry so that they could get through. And so God has a plan for you. We always, kiddos, tell you that. But God has it's not just like this big idea. God cares about the details of your life. So this week, even the little things that you might think, God doesn't care about that, or that's just something silly that I have to deal with on my own, I want you to pray and I want you to give that to God and ask God to take care of the little details as well. No matter how big or small, share it with God and He will take care of you, and He will help you to get through that time, and He will take care of the little details. Let's pray. God, we thank you that you are such a big God, that you do amazing things for us. God, so many things you do, we overlook, and we think that maybe that's because of our works, or we think that we've worked hard to obtain that, or that it's just because that's all by chance. But God, we know that every good thing comes from you. So God, may we recognize the big things that you do in our life. And Father, may we recognize those small things. And when it's hard for us to see those, God, just open up our eyes. Send someone in our life to help us with that, a godly person that can show us your will and your purpose and what's going on. But God, just keep us close to you so that we can see those things as you would have us to see them. God, I thank you for our kiddos, and I pray for them as they're going through and growing up in a crazy time in our world. And Father, may you just, again, keep them close to you so that they know that you love them. As a church, help us to show them that as well. And God, it's in everything that we do, we pray that we glorify your name. It's your name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, Croswell. Join us as we sing this morning.
It's the light that pierces through you to the darkest hidden place. It knows
I can see. The water's raging at my feet. I can feel the breath of those surrounding me. I can hear the sound of nations rising up. We will not be overtaken. We will not be overcome. I can walk down this dark and painful road. I can face every fear of the unknown. I can hear all God's children singing out. We will not be overtaken. We will not be overcome. The same power that rose Jesus from the grave, the same power that commits a dead to wake, lives in us, lives in us. The same power that moves mountains when he speaks, the same power that can calm a raging sea, lives in us, lives in us. He lives in us. Promises untrue in his strength. There is nothing we can't do. Yes, we know there are greater things in store. We will not be overtaken. We will not be overcome. The same power that rose Jesus from the grave, the same power that commands the dead to wake.
I want to say thank you to everyone who put the music together this morning for the service. Barbara is going to start putting a group together to sing, and so be in prayer for her as she works with her group. We're trying to get more people included. I know our time limit is short, but we're going to try to get more people involved in the service. Some of you are wondering when we're going to go back inside. The Lord has not led me to that yet. We're going to have a deacon's meeting tomorrow night. We're going to talk about these things. We're also going to talk about the Lord's Supper. We were supposed to have it today, but I need to work out the logistics with the deacons. So we'll plan that in the next couple of weeks to have the Lord's Supper. But you just be praying for us as we make decisions. We've made it through the hot summer, and now we're coming into nicer weather. So I think it would be wise for us to stay outside for another month or two at least to see how things are going to happen when the fall gets here and what's going to happen. Because some churches are actually moving outside now that have been inside because of COVID cases. So I don't want to jump the gun on this. And you've been very patient and cooperative in this, and I just thank you so much for that. And also a word about Sunday school. Everyone did a great job with Sunday school last Sunday. You all wore masks. You all did good going in and out the right doors. And I just thank you for that. So I hope you'll be staying for Sunday school today also. If you would, join me in prayer. Father, thank you today so much for the gift of worship. Thank you for allowing us to come today to worship you. And Lord, this past several months, it's been an experience for us. Things are not what we consider normal, but things are okay, Lord. You've taken care of us, and you have provided a way for us to worship you. Lord, I think you're teaching us a lesson for things yet to come, because, Lord, I think we as Christians are going to have to continue to be creative in our ability to worship you as things continue to change in our world. Father, today, as we continue to walk through 1 Peter, the lesson today, Lord, is you gave it to us right now for this very moment. So I just pray, Lord, that we'll listen to what your word says and we'll take it and apply it directly to our lives right now, Lord, so that we can be the shining lights in this world that we have right now. Lord, we just trust this moment to you that you'll speak to our hearts. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I know all of you will agree with me that we are living in very difficult and strange times, but God continues to bless. In our own nation, we're struggling in so many ways. We're struggling politically. We're struggling socially. We're struggling medically. Just so many things, educationally. You just name it. All those areas we're struggling in, trying to figure out, trying to get things right. And I believe that this is the time that God wants his church to step up. We've been learning the last few weeks from 1 Peter, who is the church? What is the church? The church is the body of Christ. We've learned that we are the stones that are added to the church. When we accept Jesus Christ as saving Lord, we become one of the stones of the church. Peter speaks directly today in 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 8 and 9, what the church needs to do. So let's read the verses, and then we'll go back and look at them. He says, finally, all of you should be of one mind, sympathize with each other, love each other as brothers and sisters, be tenderhearted and keep a humble attitude. Don't repay evil for evil. Don't retaliate with insults when people insult you. Instead, pay them back with a blessing. That is what God has called you to do, and he will grant you his blessing. Let's go back and look at this verses. I love what he says at the very beginning. He says, finally, all of you should be of one mind. What does it mean to be of one mind? It doesn't mean that we have to all think exactly the same. What it means is that we have to work in harmony. If you know anything about a ball team or a orchestra or a band or anything like that, you know that all the members have to work together to get the best result. They all have different positions. They all have different parts, but when they work together, it is a beautiful thing, whether it be a football team or an orchestra or a choir or whatever. When everyone works together and they have the same goal in mind, then it all turns out very nicely. That is what he's talking about us as Christians. We need to be of one mind, each one of us doing our part for the good of the whole. And the whole is for the church to bring glory to God, our Heavenly Father. That is our goal in everything we do, is for God to be glorified. We lift up Christ to a dying world so that they can come to know him as Savior and Lord, and then we bring them up, nurture them in their knowledge of Christ so that their lives can reflect Jesus and bring glory to God. Then he goes on to say, sympathize with each other. Love each other as brothers and sisters. This really hit home with me when I read this verse. When it says, love each other as brothers and sisters. I have four sisters. Three are still alive. And we can argue and we can fight. And me being the only boy in the family, I love to pick on them. But when it all comes down to the bottom line, we still love each other. And we would lay down our lives for each other. We'd do whatever it would take for each other as brothers and sisters. And when he says here to sympathize with each other, that means to show genuine concern, genuine compassion to others around us. He goes on to say, be tenderhearted and keep a humble attitude. God has to work on my tenderheartedness and humble attitude sometimes. And I think we need to recognize that and let him have his way in our lives, because there's so many people that are scared right now, so many people that are angry right now, so many people that are hurting right now, and they need someone to reach out with a tender heart. They need to be shown compassion and love in this moment that we're going through in the world right now. So may we as Christians be that Band-Aid for the world right now. May we help heal the hurt. May God heal the hurt through us as we reach out with a tender heart and a humble attitude. In verse 9, he says, don't repay evil for evil. Don't retaliate with insults when people insult you. It's so easy when someone does something wrong to us to lash back at them. That is the human nature in us. That is the sinful nature in us that wants to lash back and get even and up them one in what they have done to us. And that's not what God wants us to do. Peter is telling Christians here, he goes on to say, instead, pay them back with a blessing. That is what God has called you to do, and he will grant you his blessing. Now, let me talk to you about this for a moment. What does it mean to give someone a blessing? Maybe we have lost that in our culture today and in our Christian community of what it means to be a blessing for someone else. You are a blessing for someone else when you allow God to use you to bring joy, peace, happiness, calmness into someone else's life. When something you say or something you do or just a simple smile or whatever it may be, if you're doing it reflecting Christ to that other person, then you are bringing a blessing to them. The Old Testament practiced passing blessings on to one another and to the next generation. You remember that Jacob blessed his sons. He blessed them that God would take care of them, that he would continue to lead them on to claim the land and to be a prosperous nation. God wants us to be a blessing to those around us. There's so many in Sumter, South Carolina, in the state, in our own lives, that need us to be a blessing. I want you to take the time this week to think about how God can use you to be a blessing to someone else, and then go and be a blessing. I don't want you to just sit there and say, yeah, he could use me to do this. I want you to do it this week. Now is the time that we need to be a blessing to others. We need to bring God's light into the world. We need to bring God's joy into the world. We need to bring, more than anything else, his peace into the world. And we can do that if we will allow ourselves to be a blessing to someone else. So will you start praying today? Lord, make me a blessing. I want to be a blessing to someone this week, Lord. And make that a conscious effort on your mind to be that blessing for someone else. And as you go through your day, let the Lord use you to be a blessing. You will be surprised how many people God will bring into your life that you can be a blessing for someone else. It might be at Walmart. It might be at school. It might be in your neighborhood. It might be in your home. But let God use you this week to be a blessing. This is what God intends for the church to be and how he expects us to conduct ourselves. I want to read these verses one more time and then we'll close. Verse 8, finally, all of you should be of one mind, sympathize with each other, love each other as brothers and sisters, be tenderhearted, and keep a humble attitude. Don't repay evil for evil. Don't retaliate with insults when people insult you. Instead, pay them back with a blessing. That is what God has called you to do, and He will grant you His blessing. Lord, may we be a blessing to someone this week. Would you join me in prayer? Father, thank you so much for speaking to us this morning through the music and through your word. Father, make me a blessing this week to others around me. Help me to get myself out of the way, to get my attitude out of the way. Lord, forgive me for my attitude even as I started this morning. And may others forgive me, Lord. And Father, may we be that blessing to others around us. Father, be with us now as we go through this week. For it's in your name we pray. Amen.